Oh, he cries into a thimble and then jerks it like a shot. I don't know what I'm talking about. Anyway, let's have another sing-on. You guys want another sing-on? Okay. This one's really easy. All you have to do is go like this.
Oh!
Like that. Oh! Very good. We should be in a band together. Let's play this time a little funky. You have made a noise when I lift up the end of my guitar, so let's go. Very good. But there's one more part of this, which is that you have to make the noise when the headstock's in the air, but not when it's not, like Simon says. So, don't stop too early and don't stop too late, okay? So let's give it a try. Brilliant. Good, some of you stopped early, but you came back again, that's good. Right, you fucking ready for this? This song's gonna feature Madness here on his tiny little mandolin! I'm gonna remember to plug my guitar in today, Matt, you'll be pleased to hear.
Well done,
I'm even gonna play the right chord when we start, though. I'll put my fingers in the right place now. Go.
Ready?
This song's called The Opening Act of Spring.
Cigarettes and sun. I've been busy
so much lately. Every time I get some time to spend, I end up drunk or sleeping in. And I miss you, you're busy too. We call each other up when we're messed up and say we'll meet in the new year. But it's perfectly clear that we'll do no such thing come the spring. But when the evenings cast the shadows on the corners of my days, and I am old and I am settled in the place where I will stay. When my wandering meanderings have finally reached their end, yes, whatever else may be, I will not forget my friends. Thursday evening, early evening begins before my phone begins to ring, with people asking where I am. I can't suppress a smile when we talk about the chances are that I am far away. It's all phased out of the plan. That's how I'm the sound of another night. The kind of night when nothing really happens, yeah, but everything goes down. In the end, I'm just a promise to pick up your phone when I'm in town. But when the evening casts shadows on the corners of my days, and I'm old and I am settled in the place where I will stay. When my wandering meanderings have finally reached their end, yes, whatever else may be, may my friends remember me. Microphone so far this year. Through the power of rock and roll and spit. Anyway, this next song I'm going to play is a really old song that I've only ever played live twice before. And somebody emailed me and requested this song. I can't remember what your name was, but it's quite possibly you. Yes, well, it's you now. Yes, it's that guy. You really better hope I'm about to play what it is yours for. I'm not above admitting that I had to Google the lyrics to this just before the gig. I've written too many fucking songs. I wrote this song. This song's kind of about my dad, I suppose. This song's called Mr. Richards. And I may yet fuck up the words, by the way. Taxing Mr. Richards was gripped by a new fear. Who would be his retirement party? Now he still had years to go before he slipped over the edge of the workforce. The question remained, and in his wake there came an army. What is this life really all about? To a line between work and living, work was winning out, and he worked for half his life, deemed the rest just being tired out. That's when the roof came in. So he made a list of all the people he worked with. Cut it down to the ones that he got on with. He paid each one for a decade from his
his career. And he thought of all his friends from back home, the crazies and the ladies and the lovers of now. He looked around the office and wondered why he was still here. What price, creature comfort? What is this life really all about? Joyful, lying between what I can't remember, what we're swimming out. And what for half his life to spend the end of feeling tired out? That's when he realized that he scrimped and saved all his precious days to eat by ices and microwaves. And he only looks forward to his holiday days. And that's when the roof caves in, cause it would be nice to have holiday homes and healthy bank statements and fat little kids. And I guess you can be happy to dream on a dream, just can't call the records for the things that you did. But as long as you're sleeping, does it really matter what mattress you happen to be sleeping on? As long as you're living, you're having fun. He always laughed at the dropouts and said he'd never live that way. But then the truth is that Mr. Richards was a coward and he was afraid. Mr. Richards decided on the very next morning to make his life and his work into the same thing. Clear his desk, he hit the road, and never retired.